shoes, better pants, even like the fans that came out to support Ricky Hatton. Even after the loss, they still was chanting, they still supporting Ricky Hatton. So that shows loyalty right there.
So I hit him with a tone. Walk in through my ass, good ass, not afraid.
We'll talk about everything you've accomplished and what it's enabled you to do for your family and your foundation in just a few moments' time. But given the family that you were born into, the boxing family you were born into, the father Floyd Mayweather, senior Shearer, even Shearer in there, the uncle Jeff Mayweather was a professional, your uncle, former trainer Roger, the Black Man, was a two-way world champion. So perhaps a life and a career in boxing was somewhat inevitable. But when you first placed the words as a toddler and started thinking about a career as a pro, how do your accomplishments that you achieved compare to the dreams that you had when you were a boy?
You gotta stop recording.
So the accomplishments that you actually achieved, how do they compare to the dreams that you had when you first placed them up in the title?
Well, I think that the film is a lot better when I was younger, because I can remember when I first went to the boxing gym. Actually, the gym was less than a block away from my home. I can just remember going to the boxing gym every day, swinging the heavy bags. But when I knew I was going to eventually be a great fighter when I was 17, and I was the best fighter in the boxing gym. So I was better than all the pros at 17. So I knew it was destined for me to become a great fighter someday.
Was that talent? Is that your mantra, hard work and dedication? What made you so good at such a young age?
God-given ability, a great father, a strong mother, just coming from a strong family background. And just right now, you know, as I got older, you know, you switch your team up, you get your team, you switch your team up, you get different people that's involved in your life. And, Ricky Brazil, he played a major, major role. He's been a childhood friend since we were 12 years old. And James McNair, he came into my life. He's been very, very positive. You know, my security team, you know, they only want the best for me. Jamie Lynn, a very, very close female friend of mine, who's been there for me, that we don't talk about. These are people that we don't talk about. Has been there for many, many years, supporting me. Most of the time when you guys see me on TV, we only talk about my father, my Uncle Roger, you know, the people that you see. We don't talk about, you know, my nephew or my sisters, the people that come to the boxing gym every day for 20 years to support me. So I'm very, very grateful for those people. That's why I travel with those people and keep those people close to me, because They believed in me from day one, just like I believe in myself.
Excuse me, sorry, gentlemen, to interrupt you, just one moment. There's a lot of people that are coming here tonight to listen to the interviews. This is a very important part tonight. People have paid good money. And not only have they paid money, but we should be giving our honoured guest the respect he deserves on stage. If you want to talk, go outside. And I mean that with the utmost respect. Please keep your eyes down. I'm sorry, gentlemen, but I had to say it.
So back to our exclusive conversation with Floyd Money Mayweather, ladies and gentlemen. Now that you've retired from the boxing ring, what aspects of the sport do you miss, and how much do you miss it?
Well, I think that, you know, we have a fighter right here, Ashley DFA, in March or April. He's from the UK. You know, he's my first UK fighter. he will be fighting Adrian Broner for the world title. So, I'm very pleased with Ashton. You know, he gave me tough work. When he first came to the boxing gym, you know, before I even signed him, I looked at him, I said, he looked tough. He looked extremely tough. So I put him in there, we worked, we boxed. And I said, he got what it takes to become world champion. And he's been on the road, we got him on the right path now. He's been extremely busy, he came to the U.S. You know, he came to the U.S. with just the luggage and with a dream. Of course, he was fighting professional over here, but then he got over there, he wanted to, you know, because they say the U.S. is where all the tough competition is at. But Ashton is over in the U.S., holding his own with the best fighters over here. So, you know, I take my hat off to Ashton. He's a true champion.
Ashton, terrific field, man. Now, the Northwest Avenue, ladies and gentlemen, was right here in the house tonight. Give him a round of applause because he's stepping into the ring for the World Title Challenge match. Ashton, terrific field, man. Floyd, 49 opponents stepped into the boxing ring and we see 70 matches were in there. 49 opponents, 23 world champions or former world champions. None of them were able to solve the puzzle of Floyd Mayweather Jr. So seeing that as you left boxing with a perfect record, undefeated on your terms, if you were preparing to face Floyd Mayweather Jr., how would you approach it? What type of fight would it be? And what would the outcome be? Which I think you're rather fantasy at the moment, right? So you were prepared to face yourself in your prime, give us an insight to the strategy, the game plan, how the fight would pan out, and how you would win.
Well, I think that a younger Floyd Mayweather that was fighting Diego Canales, or Floyd Mayweather that was active, I probably beat the older Floyd Mayweather because he was more active. You know, I feel like any athlete is more sharper if they're more active. And when I was younger, I was more active. Where you know, now I'm a lot older, so you know, I just use, you know, wise tricks. You know, so I've been around the sport so long. I'm a veteran in the sport, so I just use, you know, master tricks. I've been around the sport so long.
That's a very good point. You opened up an entire philosophical debate in the fourth group for them. You're saying it's the activity of the younger Floyd Mayweather, but would he have the ring smarts and grind and ring craft of the more experienced Floyd Mayweather?
But to be able to beat so many early on in my career, I beat a lot of guys that had way more experience than I did, so I had a sharp mind then. Even when I was young, I had a sharp mind. But, you know, the sport has been great to me. The fans have been great to me. And I just want to take my hat off and say thank you to everyone that came out to support this event. I really want to say thank you because you guys are the ones that make me, you guys are the ones that made me go work hard, dedicate myself, push myself to the limit, so I can move from there to the end.
Last question in your boxing career as you stand for it, because you're a surefire first ballot Hall of Famer, but as you know, that comes 5 years after your retirement. Now, you said during an interview with BBC World Service a couple of days ago that you received a 9-figure offer to return to the boxing ring. Just elaborate on that for us. Where did that offer come from, if you could divulge that, and how closely did you or are you considering?
Well, it's just like the other MC said, your friend was up here talking. You know, it came from more than just one country. I've been offered numerous amounts of money from different countries. As of right now, I don't have the urge. You know, everything I think about just helping fighters get to the next level. You know, the ultimate goal is to find the next Floyd Mayweather. Whether we find the next Floyd Mayweather in the UK or the US. You know, I want to see a good fighter come along and break my record, break all my records, you know, and be a blockbuster.
So you moved into the promotional business.
Absolutely.
There's 19 promotions going on. Given your early experiences with Top Rank and any decisions to become your own man and your voice, what type of promoter are you going to be for young fighters that you go to the go?
Well, I don't think, like, you know, the promoters from the past, they don't have the same vision as the fighter. Well, they can't see what the fighter can see because they never got inside the ring. You know, this is a lot of people don't know about the fight business, what's been going on for years. The promoter worries more about making more money than the fighter. When we believe in the talent, and the talent making the most money. So that's what I brought to the sport. That's totally different. Keeping 100% of the revenue, that's what I did in the sport of boxing. You know, in a 19-year career, I was just very, very sharp. And I had a very, very shrewd businessman in Al Hamian. And this guy, you know, he made somewhere upwards of 800 million in the sport of boxing. So, you know, I'm truly nice.
Jordan, you truly, that's what you say, you're the highest rated athlete in the history of the sport for 2 years in a row. You ranked as the number one rated athlete in sports, period. And we're getting some assistance from our friends in front of us here saying, I'm the best. I don't think if anybody's going to dispute that assertion or anything like that.
I think that that's not as good as like this, you know, getting younger. You know, as you get older, you grow mentally, you know, you get along with more physical. So when I was younger, I was a lot more flamboyant, a lot more flashy. But as I got older, I got more wiser and more settled. But I'm trying to find Rich Floyd Mayweather. That's our ultimate goal.
Where are you looking for the next Floyd Mayweather? You're saying you've got Ashley Trevor Fieldman out of the UK, you've got a whole host of fighters in the United States. How far does your scouting network spread in order to find somebody as good as you, who can surpass your accomplishments in the boxing ring? How far across the globe are you looking?
Everything takes time. Everything takes time. We're not in a rush. But my short-term goal is to help Ashley become world champion. I want to push him over to help him. I want him to bring the championship back to the UK.
You're the best in my family. I'm going to be supporting you, man. My name is a contradiction for it. Because you said, as you got older, you're less flashy, you're less brash. But yesterday on Instagram, there's a peek inside your private jet, man. So, that's a peek inside your private jet. You've got whole fleets of cars. Tell us about the lifestyle, the money you've earned, 800 million in the boxing ring. What's the most extravagant purchase you made for yourself or somebody else?
I don't really know. I don't really look at it like that. You know, the cars, everything that I've collected, that's been years and years of just hard work. I mean, I didn't go out and rob or cheat or steal it. I'm out there working hard. I earn it the honest way. You know, I'm an honest guy. I'm a stand-up guy. I have to receive, I'm going out there to earn it the hard way.
But it's certainly been that in the hardest sports of all, the game of professional boxing. The nickname change from Prissy Boy to Money.
Yes.
The company name is the Money Team.
Yes.
Tell us, what does money mean to you? What does it represent? What's the philosophy behind the brand and the thinking with that nickname switch?
It's just comfort. You know, a lot of times, you know, negative press sells, well, a lot more people, they get a lot more, negative press get a lot more coverage than positive press. Just no different from when you wake up in the morning and you turn on the news, the first thing you see is something negative. You never turn on the news or watch something, you see the whole news, everything is just positive. So, of course, I appreciate the UK fans because no matter what they have said about me in you know, social media can paint a picture a certain way, these fans still embrace me with open arms and never judge me, and I can appreciate that.
Now that you retire, and it's not the routine of going to the gym, preparing for a fight, going through the whole set of calisthenics and training exercises in the boxing gym, describe for us if you can what a typical day is like now for a retired Floyd Money Mayweather.
Traveling the world, getting involved in different businesses, and trying to make a difference in the world. You know, if I can help in any way, you know, not just being able to help the American citizens. Of course, I want to help the Americans first. Because, you know, I believe in red, white, and blue, but this is red, white, and blue, so, you know, it's the same level here.
You're talking about making a difference.
Yes.
You have the Floyd Mayweather Jr. Foundation. Just explain for us what the philosophy behind the foundation is and what we're able to do to improve the lives of children and others who are perhaps not as fortunate at this point in their development.
Well, we know, well, as we all know, with technology, everything is all about computers. So what we try to do is, you know, with schools that's less fortunate, that's in the urban communities, you know, over in America, I'm pretty sure you guys, over in the UK, you guys have, you know, an urban community in poverty. And so we're trying to help those certain areas, build those certain areas, and help those children, let them know that they have the same opportunities that I have. Give them the same chance that I have. If I'm in a position to give a child that chance, that's what I should do. So that's what me and my team do on a regular. We feed the homeless because poverty is huge, not just in the U.S. but all around the world.
So when you talk about looking into different businesses, expanding your portfolio into different businesses. Now, famously, perhaps outside the fight against Pacquiao, you were unbranded, right? No endorsements on the shorts, no endorsements on the road. What makes you decide to go into a business opportunity? First of all, why do you have no branding when you're short and you were boxing? Why did you not feel any company was a good match for your endorsement wise?
I truly feel that a patch, a certain brand doesn't mean you're going to compete any better. That doesn't mean you're going to have, I don't have anything against none of the top brands. Nike is a good brand, Under Armour is a good brand, Reebok is a good brand, Adidas is a good brand, and the list goes on and on. But I faced all those brands. You know, Pacquiao was with Nike, and Canelo was with Under Armour, but you guys see the results. And it's so crazy that, you know, when I think back to the Pacquiao fight, you know, the city was just unbelievable. You know, the biggest fight in sports history. So one of the hotels that was across from the MGM Grand, I think it was a Tropicana. Nike had bought, you know, everybody was buying different billboards. So Pacquiao had a billboard, his whole face, down the Tropicana Hotel, I think Nike paid to put it down the hotel, because my face is down the MGM Grand, and my picture still is up on the MGM Grand, and they want me to fight again. But the crazy thing is this, as soon as the fight was over, a few hours later, the whole banner was sitting there. The whole banner was gone. So it was crazy, but you know, I think back on certain things like that. I think, you know, of course, I had a remarkable career, and sometimes I sit and just by myself and just think back when I was a kid, how I used to just lay in bed and talk about it, you know, talk about my career, what I was going to do, get up in shadow box all day, hoping and dreaming and just wishing that someday I would become the best thing. It came true.
You certainly did come true. As we pointed out before, your mantra, hard work, dedication.
Yes.
How did that manifest itself in your particular case?
I never stopped believing. You know, I don't believe in settling for less. If someone tell me that I can't accomplish something, I just don't listen. You know, I go in my zone, and run in my zone, I feel like nobody in the world can beat me. Nobody in the world can beat me.
Well, Floyd, that closes the mark. I think it's a perfect summation of your entire career. You said that when he's at his best, no one in the world can beat him. No one in the world can defeat him. And at the conclusion of a 19-year professional career, Floyd Mayweather retired with his record, perfect record, intact. 49 fights, 49 wins, 26 of those inside the distance, and a total of 12 worlds of gold across 5 different world divisions. Ladies and gentlemen, please, another generous round of applause for our special guest tonight, all the way from Las Vegas, Nevada, Floyd Money Mayweather, ladies and gentlemen. Floyd Money Mayweather, documented that you've been almost perfect for boxing wellness from a very young age. I've got one question that points to the two. What is your first boxing memory? And who was your boxing hero growing up?
My first boxing memory, I always go back to Tawasi Boxing Club. That's the boxing club that I started in Michigan. I always go back to when I was a little kid. and I used to run around a whole boxing gym every day. Probably 4 or 5 years old, every day. What's the other question? Oh, who was my boxing hero? When I used to watch boxing, I used to just watch everyone. I used to watch all the legendary champions. I mean, it was so many champions. I can't just name just one, because there's a lot of champions that don't get talked about, like Aaron Pryor and Alexis Abuel and different fighters like that. Larry Holmes, Michael Dokes. There's so many legendary champions that people don't talk about. But there's so many champions that I really look up to, that I just admire. And I took a little bit from everyone and just added it to my fight game.
My question for you is, you've been a great champion, you've been champion for 19 years. You know, what would you have done if you didn't have boxing? I mean, what was your real passion if it wasn't boxing?
I can't really say if I wasn't a fighter, what I would be doing. You know, I think that I was molded into a fighter at a young age. I think my father and mother knew what they wanted me to do at a young age. I think whatever you want your child to do, if you want your child to be a lawyer, that's what you start. I mean, you put that in your child at a very, very young age, force it on the child, and suddenly your child will become a great lawyer. My mom and my dad, you know, basically forced boxing on me. And when I was a kid, that's all I knew. I've done a lot of other sports, but boxing has always been the greatest one.
Who do you think now has the talent and capability to reach to your heights?
Well,
I think it's a little different now, because I was the world champion. I'm a world champion early to where now we got like living world champions over there to make it like 26, 27, 28. I'm a world champion at 21 years old. So it's a lot of good time. But we'll just have to see. Time will tell.
If you're a betting man, would you put your money on Amir Khan or Saul Canelo Alvarez?
As of right now, my whole focus is Ashley Hill Payne. You know, that's my champion. You know, it's all about me running promotions. You know, I think that's the problem in the sport of boxing. I think that we worry about too many other things. My whole focus is my company and my fighters. And my whole focus is taking my fighters to the next level. That's what we're focused on at this particular time.
Do you get nervous? Do you panic? Are you really confident when you answer the question? What do you get?
Every time I approach a fight, my action is always the same. My action is going to be what it's going to be. But the outcome is what it's going to be. So when you have a mindset like that, normally everything goes out okay. But I think the fighters and the people that come on short, they're putting up a lot of pressure on themselves. The fighters that get nervous, the fighters that worry, the fighters that decide to train with them.
So you mean you're going to win?
I believe.
49 tried, 49 failed. Which of the victories was the most sweetest?
Number 48. It would be most likely the Pacquiao fight. You know, because that record breaking over 77 billion that we did at the gate. And of course, I made 336 minutes. So I would say winning Pacquiao fight.